I'm not ashamed of my testimony. I'm not ashamed of the rape or the molestation. Y'all ain't talking to me. I'm not ashamed of the bankruptcy. I'm not ashamed of the divorce. I'm not ashamed. Come on, hear somebody. Of the alcoholism. There is nothing in the past, my God, that you can cause me to be ashamed of, because it is the shame that the world tries to stigmatize me that has caused me to rejoice in this thing. Haven't you heard? Don't you know that the King of Glory sits high and he looks low? Haven't you heard that the heavens is the throne and the earth is his footstool? Haven't you heard that his eyes are upon the righteous and his ears are open to their cry? Haven't you heard, my God, that he says, I am the head and not the tail, above and not underneath? Haven't you heard, my God, that my season of rejoicing has come? My God, and if you were really connected to me, if you were really, amen, my friend, if you were really my covenant partner, you would rejoice with me. My God, to explain to you what God did for me. And so David says, Lord, oh my God, you were strong in the king's castle. Well, I wish I had a witness up in here today. Come on, y'all can have a seat. I'm going to get some. David, amen, begins to tell his story. Can I tell you a little bit about David? He was a shepherd boy. He was an eighth son. And the Bible says that he was running. All his brothers were masculine, head chest up. The women would look at them and think they were fine. They had six packs. But David didn't look like the rest of them. He was just a shepherd boy. But they underestimated the vision, amen, that he had on the inside. They looked at him and thought about his physicality. And they thought that they summed him up. The name was the weakest among these. But I'm so glad that when everybody says that you're the weakest, I can testify and say that you're the greatest. Come on, hear somebody. Because the last shall be first and the first shall be last. Look at somebody and say, this is my story. My God, and let me tell you about David's story. Amen. Now somebody comes to anoint the next king of Israel. They said, go get the sons of Jesse. My God, and the sons of Jesse. Now that's how y'all know who Obed is. Obed, amen, is David's grandfather. Because Jesse was his daddy. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And so, amen, he says, go get the sons of Jesse. Amen. And Jesse's sons line up. They get the first seven. And the man looks him up. He said, nah, you ain't the one. He said, nah, you ain't the one. He said, nah, you ain't the one. He said, is there anybody else in the household of Jesse? He said, there's still one in the field, but I don't think that's the one you want. He said, yeah, go get him. Let me just look at him. And so when David comes, glory be to God, David stands before the man. He said, you're the one. Oh, text somebody and say, you're it. Text somebody and say, you're it, you're it, you're it, you're it, you're it. So David, amen, they get it all. Says, I got to pour the all upon you. You're the one God chose. You were as a shepherd boy. My God, but he said, David says, I got experience to be king. He said, what experience you had? He said, well, he said, when the bear came to eat my sheep, I wrestled him down too. Come on, here, somebody. When the lion came, I got him too. My God, he said, I understand. So he anoints him. Now that's part one of the story. Now, amen, he got to hear of a giant called Goliath. Somebody say Goliath.
Goliath.
Man, you thought that was it, the bear and the lion. Uh-uh, check this out. He got another battle to face. Goliath is on the scene making fun of the armies of God. Goliath, amen, with his 15-20 foot, whatever size self, my God was telling everybody, I'm going to kill y'all today. And David said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine that is making fun of the armies of God? He said, who is he? He said, I got him. He said, David, you're just a little lad. You don't know what you're talking about. You ain't even a man of war. His brothers looked at him and said, the only purpose that you're here for is to bring us food. Give us our cakes and go home, shepherd boy. My God, they dissed him in front of everybody. And then he said, all right, I understand, but I can handle this. Saul looked at him and said, you can handle this? He said, yes, sir, I can handle this. He said, give that boy some equipment with his crazy self. And so they began to put the armor all day. They said, man, this stuff too heavy for me. He said, I don't know how to work this. I'm a country girl. Come on here, somebody. Every now and then you need a good old country girl. Come on here, somebody. Sometimes them city girls just can't do it right. Come on here, somebody. They said to get their hands dirty. But every now and then, that you come on, a country man that's on the scene and all that change of tire, new shop, right? Come on. Ain't nothing worse than a man that can't do it. I don't care what y'all say. That elevates the life out of me when a man can't do something. Take a class with a skill, do something. Jesus. Help me, Holy Ghost, but that is neither here nor there. My God. We crazy up in here. Anyways, I don't even know where to go from there. Mission. So, amen, they say he's not going to give me my 5 smooth stones. Y'all know that. Boop, boop, boop. Cool. Now they got all these wars start to break out.